I'm just amazed and thankful that I'm still here. And I really couldn't catch my breath. I bought an O2 meter. It was in the low 80s, high 70s. And being a former Navy medic, I knew that was not good. I got to the hospital here, and after that, I don't remember anything.
He was on ECMO for 9 days, and then he got off the ventilator after 16 days. ECMO is a bridge. Most of the time in patients with lung disease, it's a bridge to recovery. So what we do is we replace the lung's work using a membrane lung. So it does the work that the lung would be doing outside of the body. The patient's native lungs then get to rest and heal.
From what I understand, this procedure has to be done sooner than later.
COVID is a respiratory illness, mainly, so it affects the lungs. And when we are unable to support people adequately just using the mechanical ventilator, which does a lot, but sometimes just not enough. So in those patients, we can consider them for what we call VV ECMO, veno-venous ECMO.
It's going to take a while for me to get my strength back in my legs. My oxygen use, even minor use, is hard on me right now. Wear a mask. Follow CDC guidelines as best you can. This is not a political issue. Your life is not a political issue. I'm not trying to be Republican. I'm not trying to be Democratic. I'm looking at it from the point of view of somebody who's been on the receiving end and was almost in one of those spaces that was 6 foot by 9 feet. And that's being pretty direct.